Hello guys, welcome to your third STL tip tutorial. In this tutorial, we will put a basic image onto the background. Alright guys, so first, let's get to it. So, we're going to need a STL texture and STL surface. So we'll make a surface, and we'll need a background. Set it equal to load image, and then we'll have impress. Then we'll give it this. We'll give this function the location of our image. It's going to be a BMP. All right. And now we also need a texture. Equals STL underscore create texture from surface. And we get a renderer and a, and you can choose the surface. Alright, so now we need a renderer. So here we go. So let's pick our STL window. So basically, what we're doing so far is we are initializing STL, creating a window, creating a surface for the background, creating a texture for the background, and letting the window hang up for 3 seconds. And then after 3 seconds, we're going to close our window. Alright, so now we're also going to need STL renderer. The renderers handle all the graphics and stuff in STL too. Renderer equals STL create renderer and use the window index and the type of renderer, which is going to be accelerated. So STL render or accelerated. We'll put this right under there. Alright. Yep. We have everything we need. So now we have to prototype the load image function. So void underscore load image. And it's going to take an image. So it's going to need the location of the image. IMG. Yeah, it seems like that. Alright, so now we're going to the STL load BMP, and now we're going to load the image. And we're going to return IMG. So basically, we're going to do it like this, IMG. We will be going to name this. Alright, so we'll name this source image. And then we're gonna name this out image. So out input output. And this is going to be a STL surface. So the function also has to be STL surface function. Return out IMG. Alright, so basically we're going to take the source image, create a surface of it, and return that to the column. Simple enough. Yep. So now we finally need to do STL render copy. And this takes a renderer, a texture, the destination React if you don't have one, and the source React and the destination React. So this is the source React. This is a destination and this is the source. And since we want this to be a background, we can just write no, 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 no for each one of these parameters. So we'll just output it to the entire window. Finally, we need to render present, which will drive it into the screen. So STL render present. And let me just need to run it. There we go. And it's always good to destroy the window when you're done. Yep. And it's also good to destroy the render. There you go. And also you should destroy the surfaces, so SDL free surface. As well as freeing the texture. There you go.
Wedding gown and
yep. Alright. So now everything is set up
getting married and then
besides an actual image. So let's draw it right
married,
now.
Really, and then running amok, like the house in the prairie, you know? And then I catch myself on fire and all these things happen.
I'm scared. Let's make this 600 by 600.
I'm not getting married this wedding dress, I catch myself on fire.
So 640 by 480 for the image width and height. There you go. And now let's just draw a little face in the middle. Hello. Make them look nice.
And the stars make love to the universe. You're my wildfire every single night. We are alive. And the stars make love to the universe. And you touch me. And I'm like.
Nice. Purple tone. There you go. Right there. See that in black. There you go. It's a nice little image. And save it as background.bmp. Now go to wherever you have this project. We need a data folder. Make a new folder, name it data. And finally, save our image as a 24-bit bitmap and save it in this folder. And now, you can build and run this. Check for errors. Yep, let's check this. Alright. You want to touch your surface? Yeah, spelling error. Spelling mistake. Alright. And there you go. There's our image. It loads for 2 seconds, and then it closes out. There you go, guys. So that was a simple tutorial on how to get a background image onto screen. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.